couple of switches in place, we also want to place some receptacles. There's a couple of rules of thumb that you follow. Some of it is related to code, some is not. Basically, code tells you, it's really written very strangely, but no wall, or actually you should have, 12? It should be no more than 12 feet apart. It's really weird, but let me tell it to you the easy way. If you put a receptacle, 6 to 8 feet apart, you're covered, and you meet code. Any kind of a wall span, let's say this wall span over here that's going to be in my living room, depending on the distance of that wall span, this one is, and that's not giving me the answer I want. Okay, so that wall span is roughly 22 feet, so two sets, if I'm not going to put a fireplace over here, I'd have two sets of receptacles on this wall. And that, of course, would keep them within the 12 feet of a corner and within about, 6 to 8 feet from each other. Kitchen's a little different. You don't want to have anything more than 48 inches apart, okay, because there's a lot more appliances and things like that, small appliances in a kitchen. So along your counter, your cabinets, your countertops, you'll place receptacles, about once every 24 to 48 inches. If you stick with, one rule of thumb is start at the end of your casework, place one, and then, 24 to 48 inches later, place another one. But look at your layout and think about the types of appliances that people may be using and use your better judgment as far as placing those receptacles, because code is just minimum. Okay. Now with styles of receptacles, you have your standard duplex receptacle, which is a thing on the wall with two places that you can plug something into. They also have double gang receptacles, which have two sets in one box that is on the wall. So you'll see a larger, 4x4 receptacle cover that has four places that you can plug something into. And that too is, again, that's just your design style of which one of those you want to go with. The thing is, you want to make sure that your clients are happy with whatever they're getting. So let's go ahead and place a few receptacles, and again we're going to start with systems. We're going to go to electrical device and click on electrical fixture. Pull down the type selector, and here is a single duplex. Okay, of course the image doesn't really reflect exactly what it looks like. Give me one moment, please. Okay, so and then you even have floor outlets, which people typically don't favor those, especially in a house. I would not use those in a house. Have to think, about things getting spilled on it and stuff like that. Even in commercial buildings, they're starting to steer away from those. But so here is a duplex, which means it's going to have a receptacle with two places to plug it in. This is a GFI, and that's just a single. Let's see if we have any others. Okay, well, we're actually pretty slim on selections here. You may have to download some. But you can do this. Let's say I'm going to do a duplex outlet, and I'm going to put, because I'm going to put an entertainment center over here, what I'll do is I'll put one here and one here. And then obviously common sense would tell an electrician to put this as a double gang, or two receptacles in one box. So, and that's really all there is to placing those receptacles. If you're going into the kitchen, then you're going to want the GFI. And this right here just says it's a single GFI. And I'm not sure all of it should have two receptacles on it. But those will be placed in the kitchen. Remember I said about, 24 to 48 inches apart? So those would go on the wall in those locations. Okay. Now, height-wise, typically, Revit's going to place these at about 12 to 16 inches from the floor. Let's grab this and take a look. All right, so let's look at these two receptacles. And we can see them right here. Okay, this would be like the living room. And again, like I said, you know, common sense would tell someone to just put a double gang box there. Or you can download some from Revit City. Going back to level one, let's take a look at the ones we have in the kitchen. So I'll draw a section through here. Okay, now there's going to be a problem with these GFIs. And of course you can say, well, actually these are did good. Typically you had to manually raise them from, you know, somewhere down here and raise them up above the countertops. But it looks like it because I chose a GFCI, that it placed these receptacles up higher than a counter or a cabinet would be. And that is very good. But in case it did not, then of course all you'd have to do is click on it and then just move it up and down. Alright, but it looks like Revit placed it in the correct location. So you think about that when you're doing stuff like this. Is, you know, is this going to be above the cabinets or below the cabinets or whatever? What's going to happen when I place this fixture here? So that's really all there is to receptacles. You do not have to run wires for them, not in a residential application, because they're all going to go to either one of two circuit boxes around the house. Typically there's two circuit boxes, one in the garage and then one outside where the electricity comes in. The one outside would have some of your larger appliances, the circuit breakers for those, and then the one inside would have more like your lighting control and your receptacles and things of that nature. But no wires are required to run from the receptacles. The only reason we run them for the light fixtures is to show the electricians where they're going to be controlled from. Are they going to be controlled from over here by the door? Are they going to be controlled by two different switches in two different locations? How are they going to be controlled? So that's the only reason we run the wire for the lighting. Okay, so that is it for receptacles. I can't think of anything else. If you have any questions, just please leave a comment or ask me in class if I have you as my student. So.